Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game.
He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home, blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
From their own 23-yard line. Second down.
Fires out to his wideout. And they make the stop at the 41-yard line. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here. And again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
Run up the middle.
That makes it 7-6.
Easy, easy, easy. Kill.
Quick pass.
And he's taken down at the 49.
And that'll be a first down on the 6-yard pass.
Heads up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
Nowhere to run.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
From their own 49-yard line, it's second down.
That's a great tackle at the 42.
Complete. He's got room.
Tackle made at the 21-yard line. He flings it left.
Makes the grab and steps out right away.
Now the quarterback's able to find a soft spot in the defense, and he threw an accurate ball for a solid pickup.
Touchdown, Tigers.
And he adds the extra point. So a 9-play, 74-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 7-0. Gets to about the 24-yard line. Northern Illinois staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk. And I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons. And I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Fires to the wideout, first down.
And he's tackled at the 41.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw.
They'll bring him down around the 27-yard line.
Gains his way to the 10-yard line. Up the middle for a nice gain.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
From the 4-yard line, second down. He's tackled at the 2-yard line.
That's a gain of 2. Third down.
And he's level at the 1-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Short of the first down. Not quite enough for the first. Looks like they'll turn it over on downs.
You know what? I think they still made the right call there.
The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
Auburn is up a score. And down he goes around the 18-yard line. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
Third down, 14 yards to go. Ball on the 15. He goes out of bounds, right around the 20. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. He makes it to the 48-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. One gains his way to the 40-yard line. He's taken down at the 39. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. Tackle right around the 38-yard line. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. Auburn's lead is a touchdown. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. And he might want it all here, and does! Almost picked off. The offense couldn't convert, and that's going to cost him a possession. Quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Auburn up 7 points. Makes it out to about the 46. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And they make the stop at the 41-yard line. Big opening. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. Didn't snap the ball in time.
Delayed game, offense.
And the coach doesn't look very happy after that call.
Well, you only help out the defense when you don't get the playoff in time. You're essentially just giving away free yardage.
It's second down and 8. Ball on the 38-yard line. To the tailback, and he dropped it. Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. He needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
Wide open, incomplete. Auburn is up 7. Turned out to be a nice little punt there.
It was just a little pooch kick, but it was very effective.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's taken down at about the 41. Tackles him hard at the 49-yard line. And that'll be a gain of 10 by the running back. He gets to about the 41-yard line. He's at the 30, gets out to around the 18. They need to convert down here and end their red zone woes.
Check three.
brought down. First down. Defense trying to prevent any more damage. First and goal inside the five.
Here we go.
Throws to the receiver. Got it for the touchdown. Will be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Into the tailback, and he's met in the backfield.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up, and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really is nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
Caught with room to work. He steps out at about the 29-yard line.
Was key. It held the linebackers there by the fake by the running back, and the running back did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
And he's tackled at the 48-yard line. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, it's a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Flips it middle to the running back. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. On the ground, up the middle. He's knocked out of bounds around the 33-yard line. From the 33-yard line, it's first down. The sack.
As an offensive line, you've got to do a better job as a group at communicating. The defense brought pressure. That time, they did not do a good job of picking up the linebackers. The linebacker is able to come up with a sack.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Here comes the pressure. Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
So another third down here, and this time it's third and long. Now he tries to buy some time, and he hits him hard at the 43-yard line.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the vest so far in this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And they got him for a loss. So the quarterback keeps it on the option, but he'll lose a yard. Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 19. We've played a half. We get a tie game at 7-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half. And boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here? Got a good, like a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later? Yeah. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Are they stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Heading into the third quarter now. Tie ball game as we're set to resume play. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 25. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. He's under some heat. Now he's going to run and watch out. That's a great tackle at the 43. Runs outside for a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Fires out to his wideout. He's tackled right around the 42-yard line.
Number 12 brings him down at the 42-yard line. First down.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That makes it second and 10.
In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. He's on the run. Good tackle there in space.
That makes it first and 10.
Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 12. First and 10. Ball on the 12. He gets out to about the 12-yard line. Has some daylight. Touchdown, NIU. he tacks on the extra point. Northern Illinois gets set to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. Losky's staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around kids like this. They're just fun to be around.
They're fun to be around, and I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really throughout the entire team. It's no wonder this team is so competitive with him at the front leading the way.
Fires to the wideout. First down. He's taken down at the 47-yard line. Hit immediately.
Number 30 makes the tackle. 45-yard line. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Makes it out to about the 36. To the tight end, and that ball's incomplete.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 26. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. Kicks away, and it's good, and he's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
14-10, Northern Illinois. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Tackle made at the 37-yard line.
Kurt, not sure what went on in the locker room at halftime, but both offenses have really come ready to play in this third quarter.
I think that's really what separates a good team from a great team, is being able to make the adjustments at halftime and then come out and being able to execute. And so far, we've seen both these offenses able to do that. It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
At the 42-yard line. Northern Illinois is up 4. He's going to try and scramble, and they got it.
He has one job on passing situations: get to the quarterback, and he did that job very, very well on that play.
Here. Ball on the 36. And they get the sack.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. He really got a hold of that one. They'll bring him down at the 32. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They try running left, and they make the stop around the 34-yard line.
Check three, check three.
Slings it out there incomplete. That one sailed on it.
He wanted his receiver, but I think that may have slipped out of his hands.
It's third down and 7 yards to go. Ball on 34. Brought down around the 43-yard line. Throws it in a hurry, and he's taken down at the 45-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Middle for a nice run. And he's tackled after positive yardage. So the halfback picks up the first down there with that 6-yard gain.
Good decision making that time on the option. He read the defense perfectly and was able to make a good pitch.
Inside the 10. Touchdown, Tigers. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. And he hits the PAT. A nice 9-play, 69-yard drive. And they put up 7 points. Auburn is ready to kick it away. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Here's the halfback. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. That's three down and one to go. Auburn's got a 3-point lead. To the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter. And they get nice yardage on that run. After a decent run up the gut.
That's good for a game of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and two.
He gets to about the 41-yard line.
That's good for a game of 13 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That'll bring up second and three.
Set, check, 390.
He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll make it third and one.
Nice run, and he's brought down. Here's the 8th play of the series. to thread the needle, and it's not going to work. Oh, no, they really didn't need that.
And as a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 21. Auburn has a three-point lead. He steps out at about the 25-yard line. Into double coverage, and that's going to be picked off. They'll bring him down at the 27.
What is he thinking? The quarterback has got to know at this time in the game, unless his man is wide open, that he should just throw it away. It's these kinds of mistakes that can cost you a game.
From the 27-yard line, first down. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Got it and brought down immediately.
Number 15 with the tackle at the 22-yard line. That'll make it second and four.
Here's the throw. I don't think he got anything on that. Inside give. Tackle made at the 19-yard line. They'll line it up for the field goal. It's up, and it's through the uprights. Northern Illinois ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Boy, this has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Just under three to go in regulation. And he's tackled at the 34. Six-yard line. They tried to get a head start there. That penalty will move them back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
First and 15 now after the penalty. Moves up in the pocket. He airs it out.
Boy, this is a great play by the safety to be able to be in a position to make this play. But he's got to be able to hold on to the football. You know, he's a big, physical, athletic guy. But you've got to be able to secure a football and make a big play when it presents itself.
Flips it middle to a running back. And he hits him hard at the 31. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Let's it go. Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 24-yard line. First down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Quick throw out to the receiver. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set, and the defense counters with their dime look. He's in trouble. Got a man in and out of his hands.
Terrific coverage, and when you clog up passing lanes like that, you can force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
He's tackled around the 2-yard line. Defense stacked in tight here. Looking for six over the middle. He got it. Touchdown. Thank you. The play clock's at zero. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
Just over a minute left. And he tacks on the extra point. So a 9-play, 80-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. The Huskies have got to be just a little bit careful that they lean too much on a star player here in this stage of the game.
Yeah, but having a quarterback that understands what this defense wants to try to do to slow this offense down is very, very important. Now he's just got to stay calm, make good decisions, and move his offense down the field.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Throws a bullet over the middle. He's taken down at about the 31. Tackle at the 39.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
He's on the run, and they got him.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
To get back in this game in the fourth quarter, this third and long is huge. Quick throw. They'll knock him down for a loss. And they'll need a prayer here to keep this game alive. He's scrambling. So the big blow comes from the defense. They come up with the stop of the day, and that'll ice this football game. They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack a defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
So this one goes final. A hard-fought, close game. 24-17, Tigers. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.